So my first part of the review stopped, sorry for that, but let's continue. I connected the hardware monitor on the V650. I started a journey while standing still. That's quite stupid, but of course. Okay, let's go on. The distance is 7 meters. That's very strange. I just stood here, so that's not very accurate. But it's the first time I connected, so perhaps the GPS is still a little bit searching for the good satellites around here. I don't know. Speed's of course zero, and we are traveling for 48 seconds. When you push this, nothing happens. It's okay. It is good for safety. But when you press it longer, it will stop. And then you can say, let's stop it finally, or let's go on. I want to go on. So what can I do? For your notice, I didn't read the manual, of course. I just wanted to see what we can see here. Not very much. Let's go on. I think we have to stop and just adjust this. Okay. Let's go through. Let's see what we can set up. 6 items, 5 items, 4 items. Okay. So this is the thing we saw. Distance, cadence, heart rate zones, back to start. I want to see it all. So just 6 items. So what went wrong? I want start, and then I want to swipe this. Why can't I swipe it? I will check the manual because I want to know. One moment. Okay, I checked it out, and it was quite simple, of course, like always. I did not choose cycling, but other sports, and that had only one screen. So I now just started cycling, and I have all the screens, so you can go and swipe all the stuff. So that's quite nice, and it works quite good. But does it work with if it's wet? Let's also check that in a minute, but just first we look at the screen. So we have the speed, duration, the height, distance, the barometer, how do you call it in English? I don't know. Cadence, it's not attached, and my heart rate 60. So the direction which you are cycling, and all kinds of stuff, and you can change it, of course. The heart rate here will show up my heart rate zones.